Hello students, welcome back. This is my third class on the topic states of matter. Last class we have discussed about London forces. What is polar molecule, what is non-polar molecule and what is London force. We have discussed about that, okay. Temporary dipole will be induced in the molecule and there exists a force of attraction in them that is called as London force, that two between non-polar molecules, okay. Next is dipole dipole force. What is this dipole dipole? As the name indicates, the interaction will be between two dipoles. The molecules will possess a permanent dipole moment. Already enagirutte molecularly dipole moment exist agirutte, dipole exist agirutte, that means charges separate agirutte, okay. For example, if I take HCl, in case of HCl there exists a shared pair of electron in between these two, that means in a, this bond contains electrons, that electrons are shifted towards this chlorine atom. Why? Because chlorine is electronegative. In madutte hydrogen ge compare madidre chlorine is electronegative, adu en madutte illi bond formation agbekadre electrons share agiruttala, a shared pair of electrons na tan kadege withdraw madkolutte. Electron cloud will be more on this chlorine atom than hydrogen. Hydrogen is electropositive, so what it will do is electron density will be less towards hydrogen and electron density will be more towards chlorine, since because of electronegativity difference between chlorine and hydrogen. So because of electronegativity difference, chlorine receives partial negative charge and hydrogen receives partial positive charge. It is not complete negative charge or complete positive charge. There exists a partial negative charge, that means compared to here there is electron density is bit more towards this. Complete agi electron transfer agirilla, electrons have just moved from or moved towards chlorine. Electrons ain agide just chlorine kade move agide ashtene. Complete agi chlorine ge transfer agilla. So this is for hydrogen and HCl, in case of HCl, okay. In case of NaCl, if it breaks, what will happen? Electrons in this will completely transfer to chlorine. Electrons will completely transfer to chlorine, so which leads to the formation of Na plus plus Cl minus. So what will happen here? Charge separation will take place. Or while writing also we write Na plus Cl minus, that means this is metal which donates the electron and chlorine will receive that electron. Complete transfer of electron will take place and the charge is whole here, minus and plus. But here complete transfer of electron will not take place. Movement of electron will be towards chlorine or density of electron will be more towards chlorine. So it receives partial negative charge. Since your electron has negative charge, so what it will do is this chlorine receives partial negative charge because electron density will be more towards chlorine atom, okay. So for example, let me consider by taking a diagram. It is dipole-dipole interaction is between two dipoles. Let me take two HCl molecules. One HCl molecule and another HCl molecule. Both will have dipole moment. Both will possess dipole moment. Hydrogen and chlorine. Hydrogen and chlorine will be there. On chlorine side there is a partial negative charge. On hydrogen side that is partial positive charge. Okay. So this delta represents partial. Complete charge separation is not there. But electron cloud is more towards chlorine, which is indicated by partial negative charge, that is delta negative, okay. Since this is also one HCl molecule and this is also one more HCl molecule, they already possess dipole moment. Permanent dipole moment is there. So this is also non-polar in nature. Sorry, it is also polar in nature. And this molecule is also polar in nature. Okay. Since this side contains partial negative charge, it will interact with partial positive charge of another HCl molecule. It will interact with partial positive charge of another HCl molecule and Cl will come over here, delta negative. There will be interaction between these two dipoles, between partial negative charge of one polar molecule and negative positive charge of another polar molecule. So this force is called as dipole-dipole force. This force exists between permanent or the molecules which possess possess permanent dipole moment. Permanent dipole, or the molecule which possess permanent dipole. This will exist, or this dipole-dipole interaction will exist in between two polar molecules. Then their charge distribution is not symmetrical in case of polar molecule. They have asymmetrical distribution of charge. Charges will separate due to electronegativity difference between that two atoms present in that molecule. Okay, so and there exists interactive force between these two, which is called as dipole-dipole force. Here also interaction energy is inversely proportional to 1 by r power 3. This is in case of solids. Okay, as the distance increases, that r is distance between these two molecules, as r, that means distance increases, which implies interaction energy decreases. Distance jaasti aagta hodage yenagutte, interaction energy decrease aagta hogutte. As the distance decreases, interaction energy increases. Okay, so this is about interaction. What is interaction energy? It is the energy between these two, energy difference between these bond. Okay, so interaction energy decreases as r increases. Distance, as the molecules are far away from each other, their interaction energy will be less. As they come closer, interaction energy will become more. Okay, so this dipole-dipole force is stronger than London forces are weaker. Forces are weaker than dipole force. London forces are weaker than dipole-dipole force because here already permanent dipole is there. But in case of London forces, we have induced dipole moment. It's a temporary dipole moment will be induced in the molecule by some changes, like by applying electric field or by magnetic field and all. We have due to some drastic changes, what will happen? Dipole will be induced in that case. That is temporary dipole moment. But here it possesses permanent dipole moment. Complete charge separation, charges will be separated. Here, electron cloud is separated from one atom to another atom. That means around one atom there will be more electron cloud, which attracts the which repels the electron cloud of another atom. There exists a force of attraction between these two. Okay, so these are dipole-dipole forces. London forces are weaker than dipole-dipole force, but dipole-dipole forces are weaker than ionic forces. What are ionic forces then? And this is weaker than ionic force. Here, complete separation of charges is not that. Charges have separated, but electron movement is not complete. Electrons are just moved towards one atom. But if you consider NaCl, here the ionic interaction will be there in case of Na plus Cl minus. It does not contain any partial charges like delta positive, delta negative, like this. Complete charges there, minus 1, Cl minus 1, Na plus 1. So because of that strong charges, the attraction will be more. Attraction will be more for more between Na and Cl. Therefore, ionic forces are stronger because charge separation will be there. Complete separation of charge will be there in case of ionic forces. But here, complete separation will not be there. Just slight movement of electrons will be there towards one atom. Okay. Therefore, ionic forces are more stronger than dipole-dipole forces, which are more stronger than London forces. Okay, London forces are weakest forces than dipole-dipole forces, which are weaker than ionic forces. Remember this. Next one is dipole-induced dipole force. Next, third type is dipole-induced dipole force. Dipole-induced dipole force. What is this dipole-induced dipole forces? See the name. Dipole. One dipole is there. Another one will be induced dipole. That means another one will not possess dipole moment. It's an interaction between a dipole or a polar molecule and a non-polar molecule. Remember this, it's an interaction between a polar molecule and a non-polar molecule. For example, there exists a polar molecule AB. AB. Okay, so here delta positive charge, delta negative charge. Dipole moment will be towards B. Now, this is a polar molecule and one more molecule will be non-polar. That means symmetrical distribution of charge will be there. It is non-polar in nature. This atom or molecule is non-polar in nature. What it will do, as this polar molecule come close to this non-polar molecule, because of the presence of negative charge over here, this molecule, there is a slight charge separation. Electron density is more towards this side, that is towards B. This electrons will repel the electrons in this, or it attracts the positive charges towards it. So this will become like this. This is same molecule which is polar, B, delta positive, delta negative, and this one will become polar. This molecule induces, this polar molecule will induces polarity in this molecule, because this delta negative charge attracts delta positive, that means it attracts attract positive charges. So positive charge will slightly shift towards this side, that is towards left side, and this side will become rich in negative charge. Electron cloud will become more on this side. So now this also became polar. This is already polar in nature, which induces dipole in a non-polar molecule. This polar molecule or this dipole induces the dipole in a non-polar molecule. This is called dipole. There exists an interaction between these two. This is called as dipole-induced dipole interaction. Okay. So here also interaction energy IE is inversely proportional to 1 by r power 6, where r is the distance between these two molecules. As the distance increases, interaction energy decreases, or as the interaction energy increases, distance decreases. They are inversely proportional. That means one increase aagta idre innondu decrease aagutte, ondu decrease aadre innondu increase aagutte. Athara interaction energy ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೇನ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಇಂಟ್ರಾಮೊಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್. ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್? Hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond. Here, there exists a force of attraction between one hydrogen and one most electronegative atom like fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen. So that force of attraction is called as hydrogen bond. Okay, there exists a force of attraction between hydrogen and more electronegative atom, like only it will be nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine. So that type of bond is called as hydrogen bond. For example, let me take HF, hydrogen fluoride, HF molecule. Here electron density will be more towards which atom? Towards fluorine. Fluorine gets partial negative charge and this will get partial positive charge. Fluorine is highly electronegative element. It withdraws the shared pair of electrons and it receives partial negative charge. And there exists a partial positive charge on this hydrogen. Let me consider one more molecule of hydrogen fluoride. So this, in this molecule also, hydrogen fluoride, there will be charge separation, delta positive, delta negative. So between this hydrogen and electronegative fluorine, there exists a force of attraction that is represented by a dotted line. This is called as hydrogen bond. The bond or the force of attraction between hydrogen and most electronegative atom like fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen is called as hydrogen bond. Remember this. Okay, so this is also a special case of dipole-dipole interaction. Both are dipoles only, but this can exist only between hydrogen and electronegative atoms. Okay, it is special case, it is a special case of dipole interaction. It is a special case of dipole interaction. Okay, here also two dipoles will interact, but here only there will be attraction between hydrogen and electronegative atoms. Okay, this is about hydrogen bond. This is very important for your proteins. Your protein should be coiled which contains hydrogen bonding, and for your biomolecules and DNA, RNA, for their coiling and all, for holding them together, this hydrogen bond is required. It plays a very important role in our biological system. Hydrogen bonds play a very important role in our biological system. Okay, this is about hydrogen bond. So till now we have learnt attractive forces. There are some repulsive forces also. I have told you intramolecular forces may be attractive or repulsive. When does repulsive forces will exist? See, you cannot compress solid. Why? Compression of solid is not possible because this is a solid molecules are arranged like this. It contains positive charge and electrons will be revolving around this. Okay, so here also this contains a positive charge and electrons will be revolving. There exists a repulsive force between these two electrons. Like charges always repel each other, so there exists a repulsive force. You cannot push it further. If you take a magnet and if take two magnets and bring south pole, south pole together, they will not, you cannot connect them. The same thing will happen here also. Since electrons repel each other, if you bring them together, they will not allow to come very close to each other. They will start repelling. So that is why it is difficult to compress solid. Okay, they should overcome that repulsive force. That is not possible. It requires very high energy. Or it is not possible only. That is repulsive force and intermolecular forces. Okay, so till now we have learned different types of intermolecular forces. That is, first one is London force, which exists in between polar two non-polar molecules. That means a temporary dipole will be induced. Second one is dipole interaction. Here interaction will be present in between two dipoles, which have possess permanent dipole moment. And third one is dipole induced dipole. Here one will be dipole, one will be polar, another one will be non-polar. Polarity will be induced in non-polar molecule due to permanent dipole which is present in polar molecule. Next one is hydrogen bond. It is a bond or interaction between hydrogen and electronegative atom of other molecule. Okay, so this hydrogen bonds play a very important role in our biological system. And even we have learnt about intermolecular repulsive forces. From next class, let us start with thermal energy. I have told you intermolecular there are two types of forces, that is intermolecular forces and thermal energy. Thermal energy will always try to keep the molecules apart. If you increase the thermal energy means heat energy. If you increase the heat, molecule will go away from each other. It breaks the intermolecular forces, intermolecular attractive forces. Okay, let's study that in next class. Thank you.